video. And in this one, let's start off by racing all the little, what are they called? Three window 34s. There we go. Yeah. Here we go. Let's see which one wins. I voted for that one. And I think a couple people voted for that one. Woo! I won! Anyway, here's pretty much a room tour. I guess I'll call the room update for now, because it's not quite complete. Got some red line sets right there, and all kinds of cool stuff. And I had a little Happy Shark thing right there called the Shark Park, and a little Haunted Mansion right there. But I found out that the batteries inside were corroded. They were mine as a kid, so don't worry, I didn't get like scammed out. But yeah. So right now I'm trying to fix up the area. Like, even the springs are all messed up and corroded. Do you guys have any idea how to fix that? Tell me down below. But if not, well, I don't know what to do. And also, the Japan Historics are sitting on another old vintage red line track piece. And I have the thrill drivers set up with, you know, the original cars. So yeah, the white one's not where it should be. But, you know, I think it looks very nice. I've been working really hard in this room, and it's paying off. Anyway, into the video. Also, yep, those are the cars of the day. Woohoo! Whoopee! Hooray! I tried to make a rhyme, but I guess it just wasn't my time to rhyme. So I sounded like a lime. How does a lime sound? I don't know, you tell me. As you can see, we're actually going to be looking at some that are in the permanent display right there. Maybe not completely permanent, but pretty permanent. It's the Gulch Stepper! It steps in gulches! Yay! I don't know why it's called that. The Gulch Stepper! I will step in your gulch. I'll step in your gulches, guys. Don't worry. That voice hurt to do. That was a hurt to do voice. And now my throat hurts. Again. Ah! I always hurt my throat. Anyway, this Gulch Stepper, these both actually have the same tempos. Pretty easy to notice. And I am not sure if this one has the Pinzoil tempo. I don't think it does. Pretty sure that one does not have the Pinzoil tempo, but it's hard to see because it would just blend in. Anyway, so as you can see, they have very, very similar tempos. Maybe or maybe not do they have the Pinzoil, but whatever. Kind of hard to notice, but they have a little line up on the top. The hood's not flat, so that's a pretty unique thing. Doesn't have a flat hood. Not hood, what did I just say? A flat roof. And the front lights, of course, it has like arena lights. And this one has a kind of corroded base, so we're not going to be looking at the base on this one. But it has a wheel on the front. That's pretty weird. It's like, oh, I have a car. I have a spare wheel. Where can I put it? I have a bed in the back. I'm really tall. I could put it on my base. Nah, the hood. I'll just cut a hole in the hood and put a tire in it. I'm smart. That seems really dumb. Because, like, number one, it's not, like, on it. It's, like, kind of in it. So, like, water would leak in and mess up the engine. That's really dumb. Has some little fuel can things on the back, oil cans, I don't know. Has some cans on the back, has a little license plate. Has some pretty detailed lights. I don't know if you guys can see, but the lights actually have like little lines. Very, very detailed, delicate lines. And this one, which I believe is a later release, does not. I do believe it does not. I do it. Don't, I do it don't. I do believe it don't. But it's hard to tell. But regardless, this one definitely does. And it has also some very fine lines on the grill and the lights. So that's a very unique design. It doesn't have a rivet in the back either. It has like one of those little clips. Has the construction tires. Completely fogged out windshield, probably so they could use the wheel. Actually has three windshield wipers. I don't know if you guys can see that, but it has three. Three whole windshield wipers. Very, very 80s, maybe early 90s Tampos. I'm pretty sure this one is 80s and that one's early 90s, but I could have that flipped. But anyway, you can kind of see that the Tampo actually bends over the wheel well. And it does that on both. It kind of bends, which looks really weird. Like, there's just some really weird bends in the car. Like on the roof, and right there on the hood, and the Tampo. Looks like someone just grabbed the car and pressed in the front and pressed in the top and beat it up and banged it up and whooped it up and bopped it up and beeped it up, and then they ended up with that. And it has a pretty weird, I guess it's supposed to be suspension setup. You can see that. Very weird looking. This one has a messed up front axle, but as far as the plastic goes, you can see it has like a little coil thing for, I guess, a bumper, I don't know. But it has that, and it has a piece of black going all along it. It has, like, black plastic running along it. And I got dirty nails that I need to clip. But it has black plastic running all along it, which is pretty cool. It's like that on several black walls, like that one. So it's not too rare, but it's very interesting on a tall car like this. And the back of the bed also has those little lines. It's a very liney casting. Very liney. And very, very detailed. Look at the base. It's just packed full of detail with all those little dots and that little mechanism thing in the middle of those two big bars coming down. Very cool looking casting. And if you look at the back window and the side windows, they're completely plain. Which I guess they tried to get out and make in an interior, which I can understand. It's so detailed, they probably didn't need to make an interior. They don't need that extra bit of detail. But it has, like, a bunch of hood lines. It has, like, little intake, actually. Like, little intake lines. I don't know if you can see that, but it's very, very detailed. It has, like, little intake lines. And it has a lot of hood lines, and roof lines, and lines here, and lines there, and all kinds of stuff, and it's super symmetrical, and has two of everything. Two lights, two oil cans, two bunches of stuff. Two bunches of stuff. And it is actually a very, very unique casting. A pretty classic black wall. I guess that's about all I have to say about the actual car itself with my hurt throat that I just hurt on camera. What? I heard it on camera! But as you can see, I got a half curve and a full curve. Old red line set. That's really cool. And I bought two of those thrill drivers. That one's still sealed in the box. And that one's open. And if I'm going to be racing on them, I'll put a pillow right there. And this little homemade, I guess, corkscrew set. I guess that's a corkscrew. I guess inside, double boop corkscrew. little holler thing. But anyway, this is actually really cool. Because if they manage to make it through, one of them is probably still going to flip if they both make it through. And if they don't make it through, one of them is probably going to flip on the loop. So there you go. And over here, I got all the little motorcycle cars. Stow and Go, Taxi, I kind of organized that stuff. The room is coming along very nicely and it should be done very soon. So stick around for my room tour I'm probably going to do. Completely reorganized all that. And that's a pillow that I had when I was little because I don't have a Hot Wheels pillow. That's the next best thing to kneel on. But I'll talk to you guys later, and keep on stepping in gulches. Bye, guys. So now, guys, which gulch stepper do you think is going to win? They're both gonna race lane 3 and lane 2. And that one we'll have to share 1 and 2 because it won't fit. Because it has Ben Axel. I know I'm going for number 3. So just comment down below.